Moderna are testing their vaccines on the new strain found in the UK and other countries. Moderna says it expects its vaccine to be effective against the variants found in the UK and are planning additional testing in the coming weeks. Pfizer is collecting data on the new strain. Health experts, including Dr. Anthony Fauci, say the UK variant is most likely already in the US. It's not believed to be more deadly. However, UK officials say it is more contagious than the original strain of COVID-19. And that kids may be more susceptible.
Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, let's start with the Moderna vaccine. Dr. Fauci got his dose of the Moderna vaccine. Any differences, key differences between Moderna's and Pfizer's?
Right. The Moderna vaccine was co-developed with the NIH. That's why Dr. Fauci, I mean, that's basically his baby at the Vaccine Research Institute there. And so I'm not surprised he took the Moderna vaccine. They're the same class of vaccine, this mRNA vaccine, this very new technology that was developed very rapidly. So they work the same, but they're different. It's a different model, basically. Of course, the Pfizer vaccine is, all these RNA vaccines are pretty fragile, by the way, so they have to be frozen for a long period of time. So the Pfizer vaccine has to be kept at minus 94 degrees Fahrenheit in storage. It can be out in those cold packs they have and stuff for 15 days and then 5 days at regular freezer temperatures. So there's a way to move it around, but it's difficult. Whereas the Moderna one only has to be at regular freezer temperatures for storage. So that's the one big difference. The other big difference, there's two other big differences. One is in the side effects. They're reporting anaphylaxis shock in maybe 6 or 8 people who've taken the Pfizer vaccine so far. We don't know if that's going to happen with Moderna. We'll see in the next 2 weeks if that happens. So there might be a little difference in the side effects. Nobody has died from those reactions, by the way. The other key thing is the impact on age. Typically, as older people don't respond as well to vaccines, Pfizer's vaccine worked in every age group. It's incredible, at 95% success. The Moderna worked great, 94.1%, I think, something like that. But in the older group, it dropped down to 86%. So you lose about 8 points in the older age group. And so those are really the major differences. You know, it's such a catastrophe right now. The first one that comes up that you can get, just go ahead and take it.
All right, Dr. Murphy, I wanted to ask you really quickly about how the rollout is going to work with these vaccinations, specifically in the nursing homes. We're hearing we may see them in Illinois nursing homes as soon as Monday. I'm just curious, once they are vaccinated, how long it's going to take before these outbreaks end, and for family members who have people in nursing homes, then how long before things kind of return to normal and people can start visiting again?
Well, this is a very important question, because the nursing home is where most of the deaths are occurring. You know, because those people are such high risk. They're older, they have underlying diseases. They really need it, because they die from this COVID disease more than anybody else. So the rollout is scheduled to start on Monday. I know in Kane County, but all the other places are going to be doing the same thing. They've identified all the long-term care facilities, and plans are going really around the state to begin the nursing home vaccination. And this is a key thing. This is a group one. Remember, group one is the healthcare workers on the front line with COVID. And included in group one are nursing home residents and residents of any kind of long-term care facility. So they'll go out, they'll get the vaccine. 3 weeks later, if they're taking the Pfizer vaccine, they will get their second shot. And then a couple weeks after that, they're immune. Now, when does visitation open up? Well, once the risk is down, visitation is going to be relaxed significantly.
All right, sounds good. Dr. Murphy, let's get to a couple quick questions, starting with this. What is the schedule for the vaccine? Meaning, I can get my first shot, then when do I get the booster, and when am I considered immune to the virus?
Good, very good basic questions that everybody taking this vaccine should know. So typically, boosters are 1 or 2 months after the first one. There's no like real magic in that. But the Pfizer one is 21 days. So 21 days later, you get your booster. The Moderna one is 28 days. The immunity from that really begins about 2 weeks after you have the injection.
Another question here. Oh, please continue, sorry.
be 2 weeks after the second injection.
Gotcha. So two weeks after. Gotcha.
If one person had the virus and another hasn't, should both be wearing masks when they get together? If not, who should be wearing a mask in that scenario?
This is a very important question. It's what we call a discordant couple. Two people, one's got it, one doesn't have it. You both have to wear the mask because the mask protects you from getting it, and it also protects the person who has it from giving it. You know, nothing is 100%, but yeah, both people have to wear the mask.
Gotcha.
Dr. Murphy, thank you as always. And if you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can head to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We're going to talk to him again tomorrow.